Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, University of Delaware's Bob Carpenter Center. The university wishes to remind you, for your health and safety, this is a smoke safety. Stairways and aisles are to be kept open for this event. Marked emergency exits are located on the concourse level on all sides of the building. A marked area of refuge for disabled persons is located on the concourse between sections 10 and 11. Marked emergency exits for floor-level seating are located at each corner of the arena. Please familiarize yourself with the exits in your area. In case of an emergency, you will see visual blinking lights and hear an alert tone with a voice message. The message will advise you to evacuate the building in an orderly manner using the closest exit. Once outside, move 200 feet away from the building.
Is Please remain standing. Guests, please remove your hats as the Brandywine Concert Band, Orchestra, and Chorale perform our national anthem. Please be seated. I would now like to introduce the treasurer of the class of 2000.
Enjoy this special occasion without distractions. We also ask that you respect each student as they receive a diploma, and ask that you maintain the dignity of this occasion in the Brandywine High School tradition. Thank you for your cooperation. And now I would like to introduce Quinn Mulrennan, Secretary of the Class of
Aaron Gordon, Mr. Jason Heller, Reverend Shanika Perry, Mrs. Kimberly Scott, Brandywine High School Administrators, Mr. Keith Rolfe, Principal, Mr. Byron Murphy, Assistant Principal, Dr. Bill O'Hanlon, Assistant Principal, Mr. Deani Lum, Dean of Students, Officers of the Class of 2022, Cadence Michaels, President, Serena Bala, Vice President, and Morgan Weintel, Treasurer. Our valedictorians, Maisie Donahue, Elise Hunt, Abigail Peters, Annabelle Maxwell, Anais Morlette, Ava Reisman, Nicholas Spartz, Jonathan Tobin, and our senior speakers, Caitlin Bowman-Moak and Kira Oppenheimer. Now, I would like to invite the principal of Brandywine High School, Mr. Keith Rolfe, to approach the podium.
Parents, grandparents, friends and family, I'm 22. The time has finally come. I welcome you as we celebrate the accomplishments of the young adults assembled before us here today. Each year, as we come to this moment in life's journey, I search for the final bit of wisdom that I could share with you so as to give you something to rely on as you navigate the rest of your lives. This year, it would be safe to say that at every speech given at graduations across the country, will probably contain a reference to COVID and the impact that it has had on our high school journey. Additionally, there will be references to sports, like that time after 13 years of losing, the Bulldogs beat Concord 40-0 in football. Let's not forget our other programs in all seasons, like our state-ranked swim and track teams, and our incredible growth and records in many other athletic programs. There's always a reference or two to homecoming dances, particularly when they are held during a monsoon, specific classes, teachers, And of course, that cafeteria food. Finally, at graduations across the country, you will hear well wishes for the future and the excitement about the future. It would be appropriate for me to congratulate you on this accomplishment and include words of hope and excitement about the next step in your lives that you are about to take. Of course, this is all true and good. Therefore, after thinking about our journey together over the last 4 years and all that has come to pass, I am going to turn and focus on a much more important topic. You. Graduates, I am now speaking specifically to you. Here are a few important thoughts. Never underestimate the power you have to impact the lives of others. Always be willing to lend a hand to someone in need. The world that you inherit needs so much more of this. Sidestep negative energy and always look for the good in others. Remember that your success in life is not measured with a dollar sign, but rather how rich you help others and contribute to the betterment of the world. Value the differences in others and broaden your perspective. You are in charge. We each choose the script by which we live our lives. Use this self-awareness and take responsibility for your own choices and therefore your destiny. Always remember that you decide how to view yourself, not others. You decide your own value, and I will profess it to you now. You have value. Never let someone tell you differently. You have value, and you can make the world a much better place. Be the leader in your own life. By this, I mean that you create the vision of what you want to accomplish in your life, not what others want for you. Identify your own personal values and don't ever waver from them. Over the course of your life, you will mistakenly focus on managing time and what you must do by what time. Instead, the real challenge, as you will come to find out when no one else is around, is to manage yourself. Be sure to focus not on your schedule, but scheduling your priorities in life. Take time to renew your physical health, eat well, get rest, exercise on a regular basis. Take the time to renew your spiritual health. Change if you only had 30 days more to live. As we leave this milestone today, start your journey by living out those very priorities. Finally, do not let a day of your life go by without serving at least one other human being. In closing, I will say to you that I, along with all assembled here today, want you to know that we are very proud of you. Thank you for your time and contributions to Brandywine. I wish you success in life and in all that you do. Continue to share your talents and gifts with the world and live your priorities. Congratulations, Brandywine High School, class of 2022. Now, I would like to introduce the class of 2022 president, Cadence Michaels.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Brandywine 2022 graduation ceremony. The Brandywine class of 2022 is special. We have persevered through unprecedented things, like having Mr. Shea as our class advisor, and we have spirit like no other. Even without pep rallies this year, it's undeniable. Whether our stands were filled for the Concord Brandywine football game, 40-0, or our hallway won for all the hard work that was put in to make it a walk through Star Wars, or we turned the parking lot into an entanglement of cars and watched with confusion and a little fear as Trevor made scrambled eggs out of the trunk of his car, this year was great, and a lot of that is stories. So go prove me right. Show your new job, your new stories. So go prove me right. Show your new job, your new school, your new whatever, that the Brandywine class of 2022 is still special, and make some great stories. Thank you. And I would now like to bring back Mr. Rolfe to the podium.
The status of class valedictorian is the highest honor that we bestow on a graduating senior. Valedictorians maintain at least a non-weighted grade point average of 4.0 during their 4 years of high school. As is our tradition, a valedictorian is asked to speak to us to recognize a teacher who has made a significant impact on their education. This year, that honor belongs to Elise Hunt.
Hello. I know I'm supposed to recognize just one of my teachers today, but first, I'd like to take a moment to thank all of the educators who have taught at Brandywine in the past 4 years. I may not have had you, but I'm sure that someone sitting before me has, and I know that your positive influence has changed at least one of them for the better. It may not have been easy. Believe me, I know just how difficult us teenagers are to put up with, but I think that just makes it all the more impressive how you've been able to impart so much knowledge on our graduating class. And though many of you have had a significant impact on me during my time here, there is one among you that I would like to give a special shout out to, my English literature teacher, Miss Winters. Now, if you know anything about me, there's probably a few things you can say with total confidence. I like to joke around, I'm super into Star Wars, and even though I'm pretty fluent in it, English is still my least favorite school subject. Well, perhaps I should amend that. It was my least favorite. I've nothing against my past English teachers. In fact, they've all been really great. It's just that the content itself has never been all that appealing. So, it may come as a surprise, but I recall just having so much fun writing this one summative in AP Literature this year. It was while we were reading Pride and Prejudice, and Miss Winters actually gave us a choice of what we wanted to do for the summative, so I picked creative writing. I remember the bell ringing at the end of the period, and we were about to go to lunch, so I should have just been bolting out of there, but I couldn't stop typing, I was just so into it. I've always had a passion for writing fiction, so that assignment was literally a dream come true. And then, like 2 months later, we were in the midst of a poetry mini unit, and Miss Winters had us write odes to whatever or whoever we wanted. I'd never really dabbled in poetry before, but I figured that was as good a time as any to give it a shot, so I grabbed a piece of paper and just started writing what I was feeling. Before I knew it, my ode was complete, and I was actually pretty proud of it. So proud, in fact, that I did something that was way outside my comfort zone by electing to share it with the class when we were given the option to do so by Miss Winters. I remember practicing it so many times, and then when I finally stood up in front of everyone, I felt so good that I started to write more poetry. Two more times in AP Lit, I had the opportunity to share one of my poems with the class, and each time I felt more and more confident in my own writing. I even submitted two poems and a short story to the Brandywine Literary Journal, and I never would have had the courage to do that if it hadn't been for Miss Winters. Not only did she give me the opportunity to share my work with my peers in a supportive environment, but she also encouraged my writing herself. I promise that if I ever publish that poetry collection, I'll dedicate it to you. After all, it wouldn't even exist if not for your excellent teaching and steadfast encouragement. So, Miss Winters, thank you for making AP Lit enjoyable and for helping me find my voice.
Thank you, Elise. Before I bring our student speakers to the podium, I would like to recognize remarkable faculty members who have devoted much time and talent to the students of Brandywine High School. Delaware State Teacher of the Year, Mrs. Joshua Tabron. I would also like to recognize the Brandywine High School Teacher of the Year for 2022, Mr. Edmund Gibbons. At this time, I would like each member of the Brandywine High School faculty and staff in attendance to please rise and be recognized for all that you have done for our students. A commencement would not be complete without speeches that share insights and represent our graduating class. Senior speakers are selected by their classmates, and it is my pleasure to honor and introduce senior speakers. Caitlin Bowman Moak and Kira Oppenheimer. Caitlin, please.
What do you do when the day you have been waiting your whole life for is already here? What seemed miles away is now staring you in the face. You can do it, you know you can. There's millions of people who have done it before you. But what if I am the deviation? What if I leave the confines of my hometown, say goodbye to the people I grew up with, and I cannot grow? I'm sure these thoughts have raced through everyone's heads at some point in these past months as we prepare to venture into the world independent and adult. I think the beauty of it is that no one is quite sure what to do. Reflecting back to 4 years ago when I stood lost and scared in Brandywine's blue and white halls, I thought the same thing, that I might not be able to do it. But being surrounded by all of you, it was impossible not to bloom. There is no shortage of amazing people in this world, but I know we have a strong concentration here. I believe the people we surround ourselves with are a big factor in who we become. I have grown into the next and better version of myself since starting high school, but that is strongly in part to who was there along the journey. I know I will be okay without you all because I met you. Meeting people who allow you to better understand yourself is one of the greatest gifts in the world. I know it's scary, but it's also so incredibly exciting to be able to hold these memories while also making new ones too. This is just the beginning, the foundation of the wonderful lives we will all build for ourselves, and it all starts today. Good luck, and thank you.
Thank you, Caitlin. I would now like to introduce our next elected student speaker, Kira Oppenheimer.
When thinking of the Brandywine High School class of 2022, the first word that comes to mind is change. Everyone's lives change obviously over the course of 4 years, but what I think makes us special is the change that isn't so obvious, the change that we have brought about, and the change that we will bring. Let's start simply. Think about how different the school looked when we walked into it for the first time. We didn't have our new auditorium, cafeteria, breezeway, library, stadium lights, and courtyard. And now, all of that has changed. But what makes it important is why it changed. What makes the new stadium lights so special? We have winning sports teams playing on our fields. What makes our new auditorium so special? Students of the arts performing brilliantly for our school and community. What makes our new library so special? Brandywine Bulldogs studying and improving their grades. All of these ventures have been led by members of the class of 22. Looking out at everyone here, I can point out star athletes who have led us to victory, star performers who have given it their all on the stage, and star students who have been accepted into prestigious schools. Why did the school change? Because the incredible students of our class called for it to change with them. It is those changes that have led us here today. Every change in our lives has brought us to this moment. Through everything we've experienced, we were shaped into the people sitting here right now. We've dealt with some negative changes too. I would be remiss if I didn't mention COVID-19 and how it affected all of us. Going online after having only one real year of high school was not an easy transition, but we made it through. We've dealt with loss and challenges in every aspect of our lives. We've had to deal with changes we never thought would happen, and yet through it all, we changed. We changed to be able to get through everything, becoming stronger and kinder and more receptive. We aren't done changing either. We're headed off into the biggest change of our lives so far, the transition into our adult lives. Who knows what will come? Well, I have some predictions. I know that we have people sitting here who will change the world. We have future doctors, athletes, professors, performers, engineers, lawyers, and more sitting here right now. I firmly believe that the class of 2022 has the talent, ambition, and ability to change the world. We're nowhere near being done. Look at what we've done already. We have changed so much, and for the better. Nothing is the same as it was 4 years ago, but I know now that that is a good thing. Look at what it did for us. We're graduating high school and off to pursue greatness, and that is a true accomplishment. So, Brandywine High School class of 2022, why stop now? I would love to see everyone in here change the world someday in their own way. We can do it. We've done it before. Let's see just what the future holds for all of us. Congratulations, class of 2022. I can't wait to see the changes you'll bring.
Thank you, Kira, Caitlin. You've represented your class well. And now I would like to introduce our next speaker, Joshua Smith. Joshua Smith is ranked number one in his class, achieving a 4.619 cumulative GPA.
Thank you, Mr. Rolfe. Good afternoon, Superintendent Holler, board members, administrators, staff, teachers, family, friends, and the Brandywine class of 2022. When thinking about learning in high school, we might picture seemingly endless lectures, thick textbooks, and stressful tests. But some of the most important learnings aren't a part of the curriculum. One lesson I've learned throughout my time at Brandywine is that there are many important ways to grow as a person. This may come as a shock, but I'm a pretty big introvert, and public speaking has never really been my strong suit. Just earlier this year, one of you told me, "Josh, I think that's the first time I've ever heard you talk." I'm not quite sure who thought it was the best idea for me to be up here giving a speech, but here I am in front of thousands of people. If someone like me can stand in front of you talking to so many people, I know every single one of you is capable of more than you can imagine. I'm sure if you took a moment to reflect right now, there are things your ninth grade self never thought you could have accomplished or overcome, yet you did. I don't think any of us imagined going through a pandemic, but we made it. I hope you all continue to grow in your own ways as we move on from high school. Personally, my desire to further develop my communication skills played a large part in choosing to attend Hamilton College next fall. I've spent my 13 years in the Brandywine School District at 5 different schools, but none of them as long as Brandywine. I've met students from many backgrounds and made better than Concord. Finally, to all family members, teachers, staff, and everyone here today, on behalf of the class of 2022, thank you for supporting us during our time at Brandywine. Thank you.
And now, please enjoy the chorale as they perform "For Good" from Wicked.
I've heard it said that people come into our lives for a reason, giving something we must learn, and we are led to those who help us most to grow if we let them, and we help them in return.
Stream that means a boulder. Like a sea dropped by a skybird in a distant world.
Thank you, Mrs. Anderson, members of the chorale, for that fine performance. Thank you. I would like to take the impact of an additional Brandywine High School staff member. Mrs. Julie Adams is not with us today, but the effects of her dedication, knowledge, and positive spirit are all visible within the graduates assembled here before us. Let us take a moment to honor and reflect on our contributions to our graduates. Thank you. And now, Mr. Holler, members of the Brandywine School District Board of Education, and guests, I hereby certify that the students assembled before you have successfully completed the requirements for a diploma from the State of Delaware, the Brandywine School District, and Brandywine High School. The faculty and I present to you the 63rd graduating class of Brandywine High School. I would like to introduce Mr. John Scrobot III, president of Brandywine School District Board of Education.
Good afternoon, family, friends, and most importantly, our graduates. I just want to take a quick minute to recognize a student who could not be here today and truly deserves to be, a student who exemplifies everything that is possible in the Brandywine School District if you pursue it. Achievements in academics, athletics, leadership, and service. Student Council President Ethan Hondashane, have no doubt, my friend, you are here with us today. So on behalf of the Brandywine School District, Board of Education, and the State of Delaware, it is my distinct pleasure to accept this very special Brandywine High School Class of 2022.
With the exception of the first two rows, please be seated. The awarding of the diplomas will now begin. Because we share your pride and excitement with respect to our students' accomplishments, we ask that each one of you in the audience to please respect this ceremony so that it will have the prestige and dignity that it truly deserves. Reading the names of our graduates will be Dr. Bill O'Hanlon,
Quinn Catherine Mulrennan, Morgan L. Weintel, Serena Bala, Cadence Michaels, Joshua Smith, right? Joshua Brandt Kaplan Smith, Elise Christine Hunt, Caitlin R. Bowman Moak, Kira N. Oppenheimer, Maze Rose Donahue, Annabelle E. Maxwell, Anise Chloe Morley, Abigail R. Peters, Ava Schwartz Reisman, Nicholas James Spartz, Jonathan Thomas Tobin, Aiden P. Alexander. Stephanie Erica Allison. Jennifer Nicole Anderson. Ooh, ooh. Blanca A. Aragon. Sabrina Bala. Tijan Mustafa Bali Bangura. Joshua Caleb Banks. Adriana Marie Barber. Aiden Kai Barber. Jocelyn Joe Bardell. Elizabeth M. Barilotti. Jayana Imani Battle. Zachary Evan Bensinger. Omar Matthew Berte.
D. Thomas Joseph Biasato.
Thomas Joseph Biasato.
It's not Tasneem, it's Tasneem. Tasneem.
Jayla.
Layla Tasneem bin Hanif McIver. Jackson Bly. Diana Rochelle Faith Black. David A. Bradley, Jr. Christian Lucas Brandt. Nathaniel Richard Brenner. Demetrius Alexander Bright. Elijah R. Brown. Kyra Ann Brown. Melchizedek Brown. Nathan R. D. Brown. Sorry, bud. Tyree Brown Hall. Sanaya A. Brunswick. Hannah Ivy Buono. Emilia M. Burgoyne. Brenda Valerie Butts. Sincere Burke. Brianna L. Caceres. Chloe Cadiz Lopez. Jackson A. Caldwell. Michael Urjan Karkani. Anaya J. Castellon. Skylar Page Center. Tony Lynn Sermonaro. Vincent Lewis Sermonaro. Sean Matthew Chetty. Maya N. Clemens. Deshaun D. Coleman. Jonathan Lewis Colton. Tyler Coons. Amir T. Crosby. Xavier D. Cross. Yalen Alondra Cruz Irvina. Benjamin T. Cura. Hannah R. D'Argenio. Layla R. Dallum. Taj Franklin Davis. Xavier James Davis. Zaire Davis. Ginger Evelyn DeLussie. Emily Christine Durrell. Chloe Nyalene Desrosiers. Juliana Nicole Devlin. Proud of you, honey. Lanaya Dickerson. Mason Riley Dickinson. Vincent Stephen Domino. Kylie P. Dinan. Lucas William Divis. Elizabeth Dominguez Catero. Marion D. Dorsey. Kiesha Lamaya Doward. Aiden J. Dunphy. Connor Brian Ebright. Sky Taylor Emmons. Chloe K. Everett. Michael Dwayne Farrell. Savannah A. Figueroa. Zayana Viola Fuller. Tremaine Sky Gaines. Brianna Nicole Gallen. Brandon R. Gamble. Isaiah Elijah Gatlin. Mikhail Gray. Owen Lewis Washington Griffith III. Shaquan Hall. Samuel Andrew Halligan. Erica Harrison. Autumn Hanner. Jamira Ann Hartshorn. Camille Amaya Harvey. Kaylee Renee Head. Joseph Henning Hedge. Julianne Lee Heller. Javier A. Henderson Money. Anastasia Marie Henniger. Ryder Patrick Hogue. Eric Carl Hoffman. Antonio Christopher Johnson. Samia Johnson. Melissa Marie Kenny. Erica Elizabeth Kenny. Travis Michael Kincaid. Nicholas Edward Kleinstuber. Jameson A. Kovac. Sarah Margaret Kramer. Sarah May Lancaster. Maria Fernanda Laranava. Brene Ledbetter. Marnasia Lee. Jared Matthew Lemon. Markel Lewis Bourne. Belle Hyun Ling. Anasia Lights Reams. Casey Catherine Corinne Lovelace. Cole J. Moss. Anastasia J. Maldonado. Anthony E. Martinez. Angel Martinez Guzman. Michael Juan Mamie. Jillian T. Mayo. Ahmad N. Mays. Sean Patrick McNeese, Jr. Colin J. Miller. Nashaya Lauren Miller. Sarah A. Miller. Karan L. Moon, Jr. Lizette Moreno Lopez. Andre Marquez Matas, Jr. Destiny Lynn Matas. Sean Patrick Mulholland. Emily N. Natris. Carrie Ronald Nobles, Jr. Emma Noelle Norton. Dajiro Argura. Jared Sebastian Oppenheimer. Kalia Pagar. Madison Renee Parker. Sanaya Alexis Pegram. Jerome Edward Joshua Perkins. Yeah. Trevor Emerson Pigeon. Litzy Pencil Molina. James Pollard. Tayton Reese Presley. Jayla Michelle Rashid. Rihanna N. Reed. Genesis Reyes. Richard John Rhodes Freeman. Deasia Lachey Reynolds. Jameer Joseph Richards Donald. Keenan Ryder. Isabella Giselle Risco. Jenna Elizabeth Roper. Andre Rothwell. Rachel N. Rubin. Jillian Marie Ruditis. Juan Camilo Salazar. Julissa Salazar. Miller Reed Salisbury. Elissa Nicole Santiago. Thaddeus Wells Schwager Schulteis. Allison E. Scott. Jalea Nicole Selby. Nathan Seldomridge. Shaba Sharifi. Zion Schrouder. John Alexander Scrobot IV. Jalen T. Smith. Thomas E. Sneeden, Jr. Anthony Snow Young. Peyton Drew Sapirak. Angel Sotelo Gutierrez. John M. Stengel. Maya Elizabeth Stokes. Rachel Claire Straub. Jacob Allen Stroh. Taylor Alexis Stroh. Nicholas D. Saltzbach. Amanda Brooke Thaxton. Owen Thompson. Ethan A. Towler. Jenna Amira Tucker Branch. Eric Justin Vandenbrack. Anna Vasquez. Sylvester Vergara Al-Qaeda. Andre E. Villanueva. Brooke Thelma Voighton. Cole Irving Wagner. Nair Peyton Walker. Victoria Justine Waller. Madeline Helen Walther. Danila N. Warrington. Zanae Natalia Webb. Julius James Webster. Gianni James Welch. Demetrius Eric Westmoreland, Jr. Ariana Monet Williams. Asiana Marie Williams. Janelle Carmen Williams. Jale Mariah Williams. Jermaine Winkler. Matthew Russell Wojcik. Brianna Chardé Woodards. Ryan Thomas Woodruff. Nigeer D. Wright. Nicir Jamar Wright.
Make sure you say ew.
I got you. Caleb L. Yanovich. Heaven Young. David M. Zamot Byrne. Nathan M. Zalatkowitz. Salma Alsamet. Princess Sese.
I would like to now introduce the Vice President of the Class of 2022, Serena Bala.
It's crazy to think that the moment we've longed for is finally here. In a matter of minutes, life will have completely changed for us. There's no more deadlines or waking up at ungodly hours. That's all behind us, and all we have is now. As we part ways, I want each and every one of you to remember the strength that got us here today. We'll be faced with so many different adversities, but never forget that you're more than capable of overcoming every single one of them. The little girl and boy who questioned if they ever make it today managed to do it against all odds. So go out into the world and make that little boy and girl proud of everything you're worthy of achieving. Peace out, and I love you all.
Thank you, Serena. Graduates, please rise. At this time, please turn your tassels from the right to the left to signify that you are Brandywine High School graduates. At this time, everyone, please stand for the playing of our alma mater. Please remain standing. On behalf of the entire Brandywine High School community, I congratulate you, the class of 2022, and wish you all the best as you continue to pursue your dreams. And now, Ms. McCoskey, please begin the recessional.